Hi, I'm Scotty. I service, repair and restore vintage and antique mechanical clocks. Welcome to Scotties Clock World.
In today's video, I prepare the movement for cleaning in our ultrasonic cleaner.
What a filthy, over-oiled movement this is. I've already destroyed a pair of gloves. We've only just taken the top plate off. I'm checking position of wheels, and I've got oil all over the top of my desk, so I'm not particularly happy with that. But anyway, we'll have a look and see what we've got. Before we start to put the parts into the ultrasonic cleaner to clean them, we need to remove the springs from the great wheels. So we'll put the going side spring into our spring winder. Connect the bottom of the loop on it and then wind up the spring, tighten it, so we can remove the mainspring clamp. Now we reverse the flow of the wind-up, slowly unwind the spring. Now we'll remove the great wheel from the spring winder. And attach it from the spring. You can see it's a pretty massively long spring. On this movement, I'll wind it up a little bit. That's the spring, and it keeps going on and on, very long. I'll put that aside for the moment, and I'll take the other spring off. I'll clean them and put them in separate bags and mark them. I'll put a link in the comments section below that will take you to a video that I've done on how to clean and grease springs, so I won't bother doing it in this video. That'll show you exactly how it's done. Right, I'll take the other spring apart, then we'll get the parts ready to put into the ultrasonic cleaner. While we're waiting for the ultrasonic cleaner to come up to 30 degrees temperature, it's being preheated, we'll take the movement parts and get them ready to put into the cleaner. The easiest way to keep the parts separated, to make it easy so you can remember what's what, is to put each train into a piece of wire. That holds them all together. Escape wheel. Third wheel. second wheel. Twist them up a bit. There we have them. I'll put the front plate in. Cut another piece of wire. We'll thread the strike side train onto it. Fly. Warning wheel. The one with the pin on it. Second wheel. Twist it over, keep them together. Those two parts in there. Oop. One, two. Twist them together. There you go. The going side train. Put the back plate in. Now the four nuts that hold the movement together. We'll put them in a little mesh cage so we don't drop them into the bottom of the ultrasonic cleaner. Strike side main wheel, brake wheel, about there. The going side, great wheel, that there. And that's about it. Everything else has got steel on it, so we can't put it into the ultrasonic cleaner. Right, so there's all our parts. Now there's all our parts. As soon as the cleaner comes up to temperature, I'll put them in. We'll clean them for 5 minutes, no more than that. We don't want any pitting on the brass. Then we'll take them out and we'll come back to the bench and see how clean they are. All the parts are back from the ultrasonic cleaner now. They're all looking pretty good. So in the next video, we'll check the pivots and the bushes, see if anything needs rebushing, and just do a general check out to make sure everything is working correctly before we assemble the movement.